的，好像。
你小心啊。
嗯。
我听过一个人，他 contact 135个人。
是吗？
嗯。
哇。但是确实听说北京有现在已经有好几例确诊的，确诊的病例。
Yes, in Beijing, the some patients that's confirmed the has contaminated this virus.
Yeah. Yeah, it's not ending. Burongisol, Buyunisol, Bunangfangchia. 那个病很厉害，
是的，很厉害。
印度更严重，印度的情况更严重。人们
对对是
啊。美国是最最高的，病人最多。
对，美国死了都已经有十多万人了。
嗯。巴西是第二个啊，巴西南美，
巴西、印度，然后俄罗斯，这都是很严重的地方。
俄罗斯也很严重啊。
嗯，是的。
OK， 我们开始。
好的，我们可以开始了。
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya。
Om Namo。Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
So we're hearing about Lord Rishabhdev, the incarnation of the personality of Godhead, and how he was preaching to all the sages and his 100 sons. They'd all gathered at the holy place.
那么上一课讲到，人格神手的化身，主 Rishabhdev 的事情，他现在向圣人们和他的100个儿子在传教。这些圣人们聚集在一个圣地。
Yeah, actually, Brahmavarta is at Kurukshetra. The holy.
Brahmavarta.
Yes, near it's in Kurukshetra.
就在库尔之野的Brahmavarta.
Yeah.So great sages, they'd all come there, and Lord Rishabhdev is preaching to his 100 sons and to all the brahmanas who are all there. He's instructing them, telling them that they have to be very careful not to get entangled in material activities. Because if they become involved in material activities, then their heart will become entangled in the material energy. They'll become caught up and be difficult for them to get free.
If they are involved in material activities, their heart will become entangled in material energy.
They have to. The material activities make a knot in the heart.
And
that knot keeps us in the material energy.
And this knot keeps us in the material energy.让生物体紧紧地裹在物质能量当中。
So Lord Rishabhdev is encouraging them not to become attached, and he tells them they should not even become attached to the idea of liberation.
主 Rishabhdev 鼓励他们要不依附，甚至不要依附解脱的概念。 概念。
Because this concept of liberation is simply negation. It's simply negation that no, not this, not this. It's just simply stopping everything. But the Krishna conscious idea is to utilize everything for the service of the Supreme.
解脱呢，就是解脱的概念，就是一种否定，不是这个，不是这个。 就是停止了一切，然而Krishna知觉呢，是将一切都运用于做服务。So
Lord Rishabh tells them they must carefully follow the instructions of the spiritual master.
So Rishabh Dev 就训诫他们，要小心地遵守灵性导师的教导。Don't
just only study books, but follow the orders of the spiritual teacher.
不要仅仅在那里研习书籍，还要遵守灵性导师的训令。We
don't have to worry about trying to get mystic powers, or we don't have to worry about trying to get material prosperity.
我们不要在那里担心，要获得玄秘力量。
Even liberated souls, even the people who get liberation, they have to also practice devotional service.
即便是解脱了的灵魂，也修习奉爱服务。And
people who do yoga, they may give up the yoga, but they can never give up devotional service.
甚至那些修炼瑜伽的人，他们也许可以放弃瑜伽，但是永远不能放弃奉爱服务。So
if we're very serious about going back to Godhead, we have to depend on getting the mercy of the Supreme Lord.
如果我们认真的希望能够回归至尊人格神手的话。
We should take instructions from the spiritual teachers.
应该从灵性老师那里接受教导。
And we should avoid all kinds of material activities.
要避免一切物质的活动。
But just simply because of ignorance, materialistic people, they don't know anything about self-realization. They engage in all these sinful activities.
仅仅是出于愚昧，物质主义者，他们对于自我觉悟浑然无知，而在那里从事着罪恶活动。
To enjoy the senses, they make plans for their just for their sense gratification.
他们为了感官享乐，在那里做着种种的计划。
And they just end up being, they just create so much envy of each other. One person envies another.
结果他们彼此之间相互嫉妒。
So material world is full of people who are just envious of each other.
物质世界就充满着这种彼此相互嫉妒的人们。Such
people, they cannot see the future. They do not understand the temporary nature of the material body.
他们看不到未来，因为他们只是在那里与自物质躯体在认同着。Just
like a blind man. Doesn't see where he's walking, and because he's blind, he doesn't know where he's going. He suffers so much.
就像一个盲人，他不知道自己在往哪里走，因此他为此而感到受苦。So
materialistic people are like that. They're like blind people who just fall into the side of the road. They go off the road. They fall in the ditch.
物质主义者就像盲人一样，他们。 就偏离了正路，他们会跌到这个路边上的深渊沟里头。
So, if somebody actually knows the truth, then they should try to help such a person.
一个真正了解真理的人，他们会努力帮助这样的愚人。
Just like if somebody is blind and the other person has eyesight and can see, then the person with the eyes should help the blind person.
就像有盲人，但是旁边视力好的人会努力的去帮助那些看不见的盲人。
Then Rishabh gives a very powerful instruction. He said that we should not accept a disciple. One shouldn't become a spiritual master and accept a disciple if he cannot deliver him from birth and death.
接下来主 Rishabh Dev 又给出了一条强有力的训示，假设不能将门徒拯救出来，一个人不应当担当灵性导师。
You shouldn't become a father or a husband or a mother if you cannot deliver your dependent from birth and death.
倘若不能将依赖于自己的人拯救出生死轮回，人不应该成为父亲、丈夫以及母亲。
So sometimes people have to give up the spiritual master because they see the spiritual master cannot help them, cannot save them from birth and death.
有时候人不得不放弃灵性导师，因为灵性导师，因为他们看出来这样的灵性导师不能将他们从生死轮回当中拯救出来。
Just like Bali Maharaj gave up his guru, Sukracharya.
就像巴利大君巴利马哈拉智放弃了他的 guru Sukracharya.
Sukracharya was telling Bali, don't give charity. When Lord Vamanadeva came to get charity, Sukracharya was saying, don't give him, don't give him.
当主 Vamanadeva 前来寻求布施的时候， Sukracharya 就告诫巴利马哈拉智不要给他布施。
So Sukracharya was not a pure devotee. Bali Maharaj understood it. So he gave up his guru.
Sukracharya 并非纯粹的奉献者， Bali Maharaj 明白这一点，因此便放弃了他的 guru Sukracharya.
Because Bali Maharaj understood that if he is the Supreme Lord, then he'll take it anyway. If I don't give it, he can take it. So better I give it.
巴利马哈拉智他明白，假设瓦曼纳德他真的是至尊主的话，他无论如何都会拿走的。那不如我就给他。
If I don't give him, he'll take it anyway. Yeah.
倘若我不给他，他最终也会想方设法的拿走。
So, same way.There was the Yajnapatnis, the wives of the Brahmins. Their husbands, the Brahmanas, were doing a yajna, and the cowherd boys came to beg charity from the Brahmanas, but the Brahmanas just ignored them.
还有Yajnapatni 的是逍遥。他们的丈夫，他们在那里做祭祀。当牧牛童们前来恳求一些布施的时候，他就遭到了拒绝。
Yeah, they came asking for food for Krishna and Balaram. They said Krishna and Balaram are nearby and they're hungry. And they knew the Brahmanas had a lot of food. So the Brahmanas just ignored them. They did pretend that they didn't hear them.
这些祭司祈求乞讨一些食物，因为 Krishna Balarama 就在附近，他们感到饥肠辘辘，想要吃食物。可是这些婆罗门 Brahmana 他们不理牧牛头们，就好像没听见一样。
But when Krishna, when the cowherd boys went to the wives of the Brahmanas, when the wives of the Brahmanas heard that Krishna and Balaram were nearby, then they picked up all the food and they came running to give the food to Krishna and Balaram. So they were ready to give up their husbands for Krishna. And then another example was Bharat Maharaj. Bharat Maharaj was he's the son of Lord Rishabhdev, the eldest son, and he gave up his mother to serve Krishna. And Prahlad Maharaj, he went against his father for the service of Krishna.
Prahlad Maharaj, 为了服务 Krishna, 违背了自己的父亲.
So you can see many examples. If our superior is not able to save us from birth and death, then there's no need to follow him or to accept their authority. If one's going to be right. We have no right to become a father or a mother or a husband or a spiritual master unless we can deliver the dependent from birth and death. And if we take that position, if we become the spiritual master or the husband or the father or the wife, and we cannot deliver our dependent, then we get punished for that. And the punishment is we may be put into the wheel of birth and death.
如果一个人他成为了他担当了这样的地位，就是丈夫、父亲、母亲，或者是老师，但是却不能把依赖他的人从生死轮回当中拯救出来，他将为此而受到惩罚。这个惩罚就是他自己就会卷入生死轮回当中。
So we have to accept these responsibilities honestly. We have to meet the responsibility and fulfill our commitment to the dependents.
因此一个人应该我们应该诚实地来接受这担当这些责任。Then
Lord Rishabhdev begins to speak about himself. He says, my body looks like an ordinary human being, but actually my body is Satchidananda, it's transcendental.
接着Rishabhdev就谈到了他自己。 他说我的身体看上去像人类的身体，但是它是Satchidananda，是超然的躯体。He
said, I took this body by my own desire. I was not forced to take this body.
他说我是按照自己的意愿来接受了这个身体，我并非是被迫接受这个身体。
And I always think about the welfare or the situation of my devotees. I always want to try to help my devotees.
他说我永远都在想着我的奉献者的福祉，我永远都在想如何能帮助他们。
My heart is full of devotional service. I want to serve my devotees.
我的内心充满了奉献服务，我想服务我的奉献者们。
So So that's why I'm Rishabdev, and I am the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
因此，我是 Rishabdev， 是至尊性格神手。
So Lord Rishabdev is describing his position to his sons. He's telling them that he is actually the Lord.
就这样，主 Rishabdev 在告诉自己的儿子们他的地位，他是主。
So because his body is spiritual, for if somebody is not a devotee, they cannot understand the activities of Lord Rishabdev.
他身体是灵性的，非奉献者，却不能明白他的活动。
Like Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, foolish people think I'm an ordinary person. They do not know my transcendental nature.
就像主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》当中所说，愚人，他们以为我是普通人，他们不明白我的超然本质。
And so Lord Rishabdev has the same problem. Many people look at him and they think he's an ordinary person. They think his body is material. But it's not, it's spiritual.
主 Rishabdev 也遇到同样的问题，普通人将他看，一般人把看成一个普通的人，以为他有个物质身体，但实际上他拥有的是灵性的身体。
So then Lord Rishabdev tells his sons that you are all born from my heart, which is, and from my heart comes all the spiritual qualities.
主 Rishabdev 又告诉自己的儿子们，你们都生于我的心内心，你们都拥有灵性的品质。
So we may find this difficult to understand. How could we be born, how could the sons be born from the heart?
我们可能就觉得这个太难理解了，儿子怎么是能从内心生，从心生出来的呢？
Usually we think of the son coming from the, through the genital of the man and imparting into the womb of the wife, and then this way the son is born.
一般，人们就会想，这个孩子的出生就是由男子的这个性器官和妻子结合，然后在妻子的子宫当中生下了自己的后代。
So, where does the heart come in? How is it possible that they're born from the heart?
那这里又怎么说到他的儿子们是生于他的心呢？
But it's the consciousness, it's the feeling of the heart which will determine the body of the child.
但实际上是知觉，是内心的感觉决定了他所生的孩子。
Yeah, the feelings of that's why when people want to have a child, they should do a religious ceremony and they should take the shelter of the holy name and purify their heart, then they get a good child.
想生孩子的人，因此他们会举行宗教仪式，唱诵圣名来净化自己的内心，这样才能得到优秀的孩子。
Just last night, Gadadhar's wife delivered a son.
就在昨天晚上， Gadadhar 的妻子生了一个孩子，男婴。
Yeah. So because they're both devotees, so they got a nice child.
因为他们夫妻两个都是优秀奉献者，所以有一个优秀的儿子。
And one Narayana Pandit Prabhu in Shanghai, he checked the astrological chart of the child and said, oh, it's very nice, very good.
Narayana Pandit 就查看了这个他们的孩子的星象图，就发现这孩子是很好。
Your son will have a good interest in the scriptures. So in the same way, Lord Rishabhdev, he conceived 100 sons in the womb of his wife, and some of these sons, they were very great devotees.
同样的, 主 Rishabhdev 就在他妻子的子宫当中, 就孕育了100个儿子, 有些儿子是伟大的奉献者。
Right. We have the nine Yogendras who travel around preaching the Srimad Bhagavatam.
其中有9位Yogendra, 他们在全世界旅行传播圣典波迦尔坛。
And 81 of the brothers all became brahmanas, high class brahmanas.
还有81个儿子都成为了高阶层的brahmana.
And the eldest son, Bharat, he is a very great devotee.
而他们当中的长子老大, Bharat, 是一位伟大的奉献者。
And other 9 sons, they become the rulers, the kings, great Kshatriya, powerful kings to rule the planet.
还另外剩下的9个儿子是非常强有力的统治者，成为了国王，Kshatriya统治着星球。
So they get the qualities, the child's qualities come from the heart of the father.
孩子的品质是来源于父亲的心。
So Lord Rishabhdev tells the sons all that he says, that you should accept your eldest brother, Bharat, and he's very advanced in devotional service, and you should serve him. You should assist him.
主Rishabhdev就告诉他们的儿子，他们应该接纳他们的长兄Bharat，把他，因为他是一个非常进步的奉献者，从事奉献服务，剩下的儿子都应该服务他们的长兄来协助他。
And if you will serve him, then that will also be service to me, and it will also help in running and ruling, taking care of all the people in the kingdom.
如果你们服务他，就等于是在服务我；如果你们服务了他，就是在帮助他来照料所有的臣民。
So Bharat Maharaj was very special. He was to be the ruler of the planet. So that's why sometimes they call India, even today, they call India as the Bharat Varsha.
因此, Bharat 是一位非常特殊的灵魂，他统治着整个的星球。至今呢，印度仍有人把印度称为 Bharat Varsha.
Yeah, named after this Bharat Maharaj, the son of Rishabhdev.
这个就是以Bharat Maharaj，就是Rishabhdev的儿子，以他的名字而命名的。So
the ruler, the king, the ruler person in charge is very important, because just like Krishna came to encourage the battle of Kurukshetra, because he wanted Maharaj Yudhisthira to rule. He didn't want Duryodhana. He didn't want the sons of Dhritarashtra ruling. He wanted Maharaj Yudhisthira to rule.
因此，一个国王、一个统治者、管理者是非常重要的。就当 Krishna 在显现的时候，他希望 Yudhisthira Maharaj 作为统治者，他不希望Dhritarashtra的儿子 Duryodhana 成为统治者。
When you have materialistic people ruling the planet, then it becomes very bad, becomes very chaotic.
如果一个物质主义者统治着这个星球， 那么这个局面就是非常糟糕，就一片混乱。
So this way you can see Lord Rishabhdev is arranging everything so that he can give up his responsibilities and take up spiritual practice.
我们可以看到Rishabhdev他就这样在安排着一切， 好放弃他的职责，来专心的从事灵修。
So then Lord Rishabhdev goes on to describe how he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And he said that he's superior even to Brahma. But he says, although I'm the Supreme Personality of Godhead, I'm very inclined to the Brahmanas. I like the Brahmanas. The Brahmanas are the best of all, of everyone.
进一步说，他自己是至尊性格神手，甚至他的地位甚至比 Brahma 还要高。他自己也有倾向，他喜欢 Brahmana， 而这 Brahmana 是所有人类当中的佼佼者。
Now Rishabhdev was saying Bharat should be the ruler, but Bharat has to take instruction from the Brahmanas.
Rishabhdev 就说。Bharat 应当成为统治者，但是 Bharat 也应该接受 Brahmana 们的教导，接受他们的意见。
When we say Brahmana, we don't just mean people born Brahmana, we mean people who are devotee Brahmana.
当我们说 Brahmana 的时候，不是指那些生于 Brahmana 家庭的人，而是指的。Brahmana 奉献者们。
So, Lord Rishabhdev is explaining how the Brahmanas are the real head of the society, and the Brahmanas are even worshipped by the Supreme Lord Himself.
Rishabhdev 描述 Brahmana。是整个社会的头脑，甚至连至尊主本人都崇拜 Brahmana。
Of course, Brahmana means they have the qualities of the Brahmana, and they work like Brahmanas.
而 Brahmana 是指的他们有着 Brahmana 的品质，以及他们从事的是 Brahmana 的工作。
Oh. So the Brahmanas are always dear to Lord Krishna. We know the verse, right? Namo Brahmana Devaya, Go Brahmana Hitaya Cha, Jagat Hitaya Krishnaya, Govindaya, Namo Namaha. But two people are very dear to Krishna, the cows and the Brahmanas.
Brahmana 是对于主 Krishna 非常亲切的人，刚才就是妈妈说的这个师姐，大家都知道，有两种事物是 Krishna 特别喜欢的，一个是母牛，另外一个是 Brahmana 们。
So Lord Rishabhdev said, nobody is equal to or greater than the Brahmanas.
Rishabhdev 说，没有人能够和 Brahmana 平等，也没有人比 Brahmana 更伟大。
So Lord Rishabhdev said, people like to do rituals and they offer food to me, and I eat it with satisfaction. But I get more pleasure from food that is offered to the Brahmanas.
主人生 Dave 又说道，人们喜欢做仪式，他们喜欢给我供奉食物，我吃了这些食物感到非常的满足，但是如果 Brahmana 们吃了这些食物，我会从中得到更多的快乐。
Yeah, the best. So whenever we do a ritual, it's customary that we should first feed the Brahmanas. Because the Brahmanas, when you feed the Brahmanas,That is like feeding Krishna himself.
所以按照当在仪式当中，仪式结束之后呢，根据习俗和传统，首先要给 Brahmana 们喂食。 给 Brahmana 们喂食，就相当于直接在给主 Krishna 在喂食。
Because the Brahmanas are the representative of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
因为 Brahmana 们是至尊性格神首的代表。
So we like to, we should, we, that, that is the culture, the etiquette, that first feed the Brahmanas and then you feed the other people.
这个是文化，也是礼仪，就首先要给 Brahmana 们，让 Brahmana 进餐，然后再接下来是其他人进餐。
So when people should be guided by the Brahmanas, and the Brahmanas will guide them according to the teachings of the scriptures like Bhagavad Gita.
人民应该得到 Brahmana 的指导，而 Brahmana 们是按照像《博迦梵歌》这样的圣典来指导人民。
And when people are given nice grains to eat when they're properly fed,They will be healthy and happy and strong.
当人们得到了很好的谷物的时候，他们进食之后就能变得健康、快乐和身体健壮。
And their minds will be peaceful.
他们会有平和的心意。
Then it's easy for them to advance in spiritual life.
这样，他们就能在灵修生活当中取得好长足的进步。
So the Brahmana's duty is to study the Vedas. They have to study the Vedas and they have to teach according to the Vedas.
Brahmana 的职责就是研究学习韦达经，他们也会按照韦达经的教导去教导其他人。
They should be in the mode of goodness.
他们应当处于善良属性。
And the Brahmanas themselves are the personification, they should be the personification of the Vedas.
而 Brahmana 自身应当成为韦达经的人格化身。
They have to control their mind and senses.
他们应当控制自己的感官与心意。
They must be truthful.
应当真诚。
And they must be merciful.
他们应该仁慈。
And they should understand also the position of the Supreme Lord in relation to the living entities.
他们应当明白生物至尊主和生物体的关系。
These are qualities of the Brahmana.
这些是婆罗门的品质。
So you don't become a Brahmana just only by birth or just by initiation. You have to have the qualities of the Brahmana.
你不应当仅仅是依靠自己的出身，或者是仅仅通过启迪就成为 Brahmana。而应当是名副其实的拥有 Brahmana 的品质。
We have to practice. We have to get control of the mind and senses.
我们需要去修行，去努力控制感官，控制心意。
We should study the scriptures and learn the transcendental knowledge.
我们需要去研究经典。去学习超然的知识。
And when we develop these qualities, then naturally we become very dear to the Supreme Lord.
当我们发展出这样的品质之后，自然而然的就会对主而言是非常亲切的。
So Lord Rishabhdev is explaining his position. He said, you know, I'm the Supreme Lord. I'm above Lord Brahma. I'm much greater than Indra. I'm the king of all the planets, the heavenly planets also. I'm a king of all these places.
Lord Rishabhdev 就解释了他自己的地位。他说，我的地位甚至高于主 Brahma， 高于 Indra， 我是所有天堂和所有星球的统治者。
But still the Brahmanas, they don't come to me to get material comforts.
但是 Brahmana 们，他们不会到我这里来寻求物质的舒适。
Yeah, they're not eager to possess material things.
他们并不渴求对物质事物的拥有。
They just like to do devotional service.
他们只想从事奉献服务。
So they don't ask me for anything. Why would they ask anybody else?
They 他们不会向我这里寻求这些事物，他们也不会向其他人寻求这些事物。
So, if we really want to go back to Godhead, we have to become detached from all this material opulence and material sense gratification.
如果我们真的希望回归神手的话，要不依附这些物质的富裕，不依附感官享乐。
And the most dangerous things in the path of advancement is wealth and the opposite sex.
在进步的道路上最危险的两件事物，一个是财，一个是色。富裕和异性。
So Brahmanas have to be very pure in their actions and in their mind.
因此 ，Brahmana 他们的内心和活动都需要必须是非常纯粹的。
Yeah, use their body, the mind, and the words for the service of the Supreme Lord. So, Lord Rishabhdev encourages his sons, don't ever be envious of anyone.
主 Rishabhdev 鼓励自己的儿子们不要嫉妒任何生物。
He tells his sons, remember, I am in the heart of all living entities. So you should respect all living entities.
他告诉他们，你们要记住，我处于一切生物的内心，因此你们应当尊重一切生物。
Because Lord Rishabhdev is saying he's the Supreme Lord, so the Supreme Lord's in the heart of all living entities. So he tells his sons, you respect everyone because I'm in everyone's heart.
主 Rishabhdev 说他自己是至尊主，因为至尊主又处于所有众生的内心，因此他让他的儿子们要尊重所有的生物。
Now some people, they think, oh, God's only in the heart of the poor people. They think the poor people are God. God is in their heart. But God is in the heart of everyone, whether they're rich or poor.
有些人以为神只在穷人的心中，但是这种观点是不对的。神既在穷人的心中，也在富人的心中，在每一个生物的心中。
So we should see all living entities equally. And act with them in the proper way.
因此，我们应当，对所有的一切众生都一视同仁，并且以正确的方式来相应的对待他们。
Not that they're God, but they're part and parcel of the Supreme.
他们并不是神，他们是神的所属部分。
So we should be very careful to use the senses in the proper manner for devotional service and not for sense gratification.
我们当小心的、正确的来使用感官，让感官从事服务，而不应该让感官 欢从事于享乐。
So Lord Rishabhdev was instructing his sons, but at the same time he was instructing everyone. Actually, his sons were already very advanced, very self-realized souls, but Lord Rishabhdev was instructing them just so that everybody else could learn and hear how he instructed them. It would set an example for everyone. Just like Krishna instructed Arjuna, not just to instruct Arjuna, but to instruct everyone.
正像主 Krishna 他教导了 Arjuna， 但实际上这教导是针对所有的人的。
So after Lord Rishabhdev instructed his sons and everyone, then Lord Rishabhdev retired from the world. And although he was still living at home, he was completely detached from the material world.
主 Rishabhdev 教导了自己的儿子之后，就准备从这个世界当中退出去。虽然他仍然在家中生活，但他已经不依附这个物质世界了。
He completely renounced everything, and he looked just like a madman, because he would go around naked, and his hair would be a mess, and he was just so detached from everything.
他已经主人生队伍现在已经完全的弃绝了一切了。他看上去就像一个疯子，而且他会裸体，然后他的头发呢就纠结纠缠在一起。他现在已经弃绝了一切了。
So he'd retired from family life, but for some time he was still living with his family. But even though he was living with his family, he was like this, he was like a madman.
他现在呢，就是已经弃绝家庭生活了，但他仍然是跟家人一起居住在一起，生活在一起，但他就像一个疯子一样。
At this stage of life is sometimes, this is what we call an avadut. Avaduta means he does not belong to any position in the society. He's not a Brahmin or a Kshatriya or a Vaishya or a Sudra. He's completely above all this.
这个阶段被称为 Avadut 阶段，就是他不属于任何社会地位，并不属于 Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya or Sudra. 他完全超越了这一些地位。
Sometimes it appeared that he was blind, sometimes he was like deaf, sometimes he was like a dumb man.
有时候呢，他好像是一个盲人，有时候又像一个聋子，有时候像个哑巴。
Sometimes he was like a ghost, just like a madman.
有的时候像鬼魂，有的时候呢，就像正像一个疯子。
And people would often call him all these names. They'd call him madman, but he would just ignore them. He wouldn't speak to anyone.
有人们呢，就会用这些称号来呼唤他，叫他，称呼他是一个疯子。但是他不会理睬这些人。他好像就他也不说话。
So we only have a few avadutas, and we have like Sukadeva Goswami, he was also avaduta. Lord Nityananda, he was avaduta.
We have a few avadutas. Sukadeva Goswami,
They're fully meditating on the Supreme Lord in their heart. So he has nothing to do with the material world. So in this way, Lord Rishabhdev, he went everywhere. He traveled all over the world. He went to all different places, cities and villages and countryside. Sometimes he'd be in the forest, sometimes he would be in hermitages or ashrams. So wherever he went, so many bad things seemed to happen to him. People were threatening him, and some people were beating him. Some people would pass urine on him and spit on him. Sometimes people would throw things at him. That sometimes they throw stones, sometimes they throw dust, sometimes they'd even throw stool at him. So wherever he went, people would give him a lot of trouble, but he didn't worry about it, he didn't get disturbed by it. Because he was so much on the spiritual platform, he was not attached to the body. He didn't worry about these material insults. And like this, he walked around the world, going everywhere. He didn't worry about pain or pleasure. It didn't affect him. So he was situated in, on the completely transcendental to the body. But actually, physically, he was very attractive. He was very powerfully built. He had long arms and big, broad shoulders, and his face was very attractive. He was so good looking that even married women, when they saw him, they were attracted to him. So, so his body was up, but at the same time his body was dirty. He didn't take care of it.
同时呢，他的身体呢又是很肮脏的，因为他也不在乎、不理睬自己的这个身体。
It was like he was being haunted by a ghost.
就好像他被鬼魂附体了一样。
So he got a bit tired of people because people were getting angry at him. So sometimes he would just stay in one place.He would become like a python. He would take the behavior of a python. Python just stays in one place. He just doesn't move. So sometimes Rishabhdev would do like that. And it describes, Srimad Bhagavatam describes that he laid down in one place, he stayed in that place, and he ate there, and he drank there, and he even passed stool and urine in that same place, and he would roll in the stool and urine.
圣典伯加瓦坛现在就 描述说他会躺在一个地方在 一处吃喝拉撒他甚至在自己的粪便和尿液当中打滚
And so when he did like this then materialistic people would not trouble him they would stay away from him
当他这样做的时候呢物质主义者就不会前来打扰他
There was no needfor him to travel, so he was just staying in one place. So although he was in his own stool and urine, the stool and urine was actually, it was so fragrant, it had a beautiful smell. It didn't have a foul smell, it was a very pleasant smell.So we can see how he was really transcendental, that even his stool and urine was very pure.
So we can see that he was very transcendental, that even his stool and urine was very pure.
Just like cow's stool is purifying.
就像母牛的牛粪是净化的。
So Lord Rishabhdev was doing like this. He would lay sometimes like animals, just like a cow or a deer. They would just stay in one place.
主 Rishabhdev 他现在就是这样，他会躺在一个地方，有的时候呢，就像母牛和鹿一样。
So ordinary people, they could not understand his behavior. But he was cheating them by doing like this.
普通人就不理解他，但实际上他这么做是为了欺骗他们。
So Lord Rishabhdev, this was his activities. He was a fully liberated soul. He was, well, he's the Supreme Lord, so of course he's liberated.
这就是主 Rishabhdev 的活动，他是解脱了灵魂，因为他是至尊主，他一定是解脱了的。
So sometimes Lord Rishabhdev would show symptoms of ecstatic love, like crying and laughing and shivering.
有时候，主 Rishabhdev 他会展示狂喜的爱。
And all the mystic powers were also given to him. He could have had the power if he wanted. He could travel in the air and he could go through space, but he didn't like to do these things. Because he's an expansion of Lord Vasudev, so he has all these mystic powers, but he doesn't want to use them. He just wants to do devotional service to Krishna. So he's crying and laughing that this is all due to his love for Krishna. Okay, we'll stop here. Any questions?
Hare Krishna, good day.
您是有分享者关心您说现在好像有点感冒了。对，晚上，因为今天特别热，可是有时候也下雨，有时候温度改变很大。有时候下雨之后就很凉，是吗？
所以您多保重。对，我就需要多喝水。好的，好，那我们看看那个今天的问题。稍等啊，我关一下门。 我们看一下，上周，雅木达提喇嘛的集，周一的时候留下了一个问题，顶拜咕噜，今天的课很受益，在灵修生活中经常想自己安静灵修，也很需要安静灵修，多自省多思考，但通过一些教导知道要和奉献者联谊，要传播。 但时间其实很有限，如何把握好，既增加内在修灵修力量，又避免走向非人格呢？感恩Guru的仁慈， Hare Krishna。
How to not become an impersonalist?
she wants to. Sometimes be introspective, she wants to increase the spiritual practice. But at the same time, there's a need to also preaching. So she wants to know how she cannot become an impersonalist.
Well, you preach according to the scriptures, and you chant Hare Krishna. You preach everything according to the scriptures, according to our philosophy. You won't become an impersonalist.
您按照经典来传教，唱诵 Hare Krishna， 只要按照经典去传教，就不会非人格主义者。Preach about
devotion to Krishna. That will protect you from becoming an impersonalist.
您只传教对 Krishna 的奉献服务，这就能保护您，不至于变成非人格的。Impersonalism
is dry philosophy. Impersonalism means a lot of extreme renunciation, makes the heart very hard. But Bhakti Yoga was the opposite.
哲学是非常枯燥的哲学，它就是它的气绝是达到非常极端的，是使人的内心呢变得非常的坚硬。就跟 Bhakti 就恰恰相反了。
You preach devotional service, your heart will become soft. Because devotional service means we have to show compassion for others. We should be compassionate to the others and think about their welfare, concern for them, try to think how to give them Krishna consciousness.
对，就是奉献服务就是会使人的内心非常柔软，因为人这时候就有着怜悯之心，他就会对关心众生的福祉给予别的人，想着怎么给予别人 Krishna 之觉。
So devotional service is very, very totally different mood from impersonalism, the impersonal path. The devotional service is based on hearing and chanting and associating with devotees, but impersonalism is based on meditation and isolation, not mixing with people.
奉献服务不同于非人格主义的道路，他的心态是完全不同，截然相反的。奉献服务是基于聆听、唱诵、联谊，但是非人格主义他们是建立在冥想以及就是独处。
Impersonal,
他不喜欢跟世人混在一起。
Impersonalists say they go away from the world.But devotees stay in the world, they go, stay in the world and try to give it, relate everything into Krishna's service.
非人格主义呢，他们是消极避世的，他们就想逃避于世俗人，但是奉献服务呢，是跟这个世界是息息相关的，他们想为 Krishna 从事奉献服务。
Impersonalists say the world is unreal, everything is false, only the Brahman is truth. But devotee says Krishna is truth, and devotional service is true, and the material world is Krishna's energy, we should use it for Krishna's service.
非人格主义声称这世界是不真实的，只有 Brahman 是真实的，而奉献服务说 Krishna 是真实的，奉献服务是真实的，物质世界是 Krishna 的能量。
Yes. Is it clear, Chinchulama? You mean by Zimanam Bunang Binchang Piranga? Can you understand?How to be a devotee, how not to be an impersonalist?
我就问这位妈妈吉，现在明不明白明不明白奉献服务和非人格的区别，怎么能不成为不是不是陷于非人格主义？
好的，我们来看下一个今天的问题。参哲维拉西尼马太吉，深深的顶拜姑顶拜所有奉献者，感恩咕噜甜美的讲课。我与非奉献者相处时说真话，阅人宜人，娓娓动听，语言和说赞美鼓励的语言有什么区别？我与奉献者在一起做服务相处时该怎么说话最好呢？是否需要多说些赞美鼓励他人的话？就是他跟非奉献者相处的时候，就是说娓娓动听的语言和这个赞美鼓励的语言有什么区别，然后跟奉献者在一起应该如何说话。
She want to know if she deals with those non-devotees. So what's the difference between those pleasing words and those praising words? And also, how to speak with a devotee? What kind of words should we she speak using the words to devotees?
You said pleasing and praising, isn't it?
Yes.
What's the difference between
those, that's very moving to the others felt very pleasant listening to her words. Also, she want to know, yes, sometimes she want to speak the truth, also very nice words to the others, praising.
Pleasing and praising. Well, when we speak to none, we should speak the truth. That we should cultivate the mode of goodness, right? In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna describes in the mode of goodness, speaking words which are truthful and pleasing. So a devotee has to be able to speak the truth and at the same time to speak it in such a way that it is pleasing. However, Prabhupada said, if you're doing preaching work, then you're not required to follow that etiquette.
然而，师的爸爸说，如果您在从事的是一种传道活动的话，传播活动的话，就不需要遵守这种礼仪了。We can
simply speak. It may not be pleasing, but we can speak the truth.
可能我们说的话并不是人语。
But we should speak the truth. But if you're going to preach to somebody, they have to accept you as the authority. If they do not accept you as their guide, as their authority, then don't waste your time trying to preach to them. So, speaking, sometimes of course when you're speaking to non-devotees, when you're doing business, you're talking to a customer or a client, and you want to please them, and so you may have to speak words which are nice, praising them.
对于非奉献者呢，在做生意的时候，跟客户打交道的时候，您可能您可以说一些讨好他们的话，赞美他们的话，说一些美好的语言。
Prabhupada was very expert in speaking to people. Sometimes he could call people. One time Prabhupada was giving the lecture in India, and he gave a lecture how people today I like hogs and dogs and camels and asses.
帕帕德是社特别擅长善于讲话的，使用词令的。有一次呢，他在印度讲课，讲课的时候呢，他就称呼人们是猪、狗、骆驼和驴子。
So Prabhupada gave the lecture, and the people all laughed, and they liked very much, and they enjoyed, and they thanked Prabhupada for the wonderful lecture.
那下面呢，听他讲课的讲课的人们都哄堂大笑，都非常享受他称呼他们是这些驴子、狗啊，还有骆驼和猪，他们特别喜欢他的讲课。而且他们对他表示非常的感激，都觉得他给了一场精彩的讲课。
So Prabhupada came back after the lecture and he said to his servant, he said, you see, I called them all dogs, hogs, camels and asses, and they have clapped, they have applauded, they have appreciated.
帕帕德
So, do these kind of things, we may not be able to do these things.
帕帕德可以这样去称呼，就是这么说话，但是我们不能这么说话。
You know, as a mother, you can speak the truth to your children, and they will have to, they should accept whatever you tell them.But obviously when you deal with your clients, your customers, you have to speak with them in a different way. They're not your children. You have to get their trust, get their confidence. And similarly,
您对他们的说话应该赢得他们的信任。
In the same way, when we are preaching, you have to be careful how you speak. If you speak too strongly or too much or too heavy criticism, then people may be frightened. They may be scared and go away. But if you can be nice to them and make friendship with them, then it can help to make them devotees.
同样我们在传教的时候要非常小心，如果过于强势，采取非常强烈的这种批评的话，就会吓坏他们，把他们吓跑，应该很好好的奉献者。
you're not a guru, you're not trying to, the guru's job is to find the faultThe spiritual master's job is to find the fault. You're not spiritual master. You're a devotee and you're a preacher. You want to make friends. So speak nicely to people. So people are very affected by how you speak and the words you speak. So you have to judge yourself how people react to the words you're saying.
人们就因为我 的说话方式还有使用的言辞而不受到影响，所以您得自己判断，通过人们对您所说的话使用的言语的反应来自己做出判断。
You have to judge by the results.
要按照这个结果来判断，使用的这种词语。
Okay.
Hi, Hare Krishna. Good day. 我们下今天问题好多，我们来看下一个问题。小草麻烦鸡。请问 Guru， 为什么 Brahma 的星球没有痛苦和恐惧，而我们地球有这些呢？是因为生活在地球的灵魂不洁净，所以必须痛苦和恐惧吗？或者有别的原因？给拜您。
This Mataji, she said, why, 在 Brahma 的星球上没有痛苦是吗？
That there's no suffering on Brahma's planet because it's the highest planet in the universe.Because it's, so people in the highest planet, they're very, very pious. You don't get to that planet if you're sinful. The people in Brahma's planet are all very pious. So they're without sin. So there's no suffering there. And another reason is their bodies are also subtle. They don't have the physical earth bodies like what we have on this planet.
因为Brahma 的星球是这个宇宙间最高级的最高的星球最崇高的星球，那里的人们全是虔诚的人，从就没有罪恶，因此他们就不会是痛苦，而且呢他们的身体他们的躯体是相对来说是非常精微的，没有像我们这样的这个世俗的这么粗糙的这个俗人的躯体，不像我们这个星球上。
第二部分，他的问题是什么？
是因为我们生活在地球上的这些灵魂不洁净吗？必须承受这些痛苦和恐惧吗？
Is it because we are not pure, we are living in this, this earth, so that we have to suffer?
Well, this planet Earth is where we're earning our karma. We're getting our karma here. If we do good karma, you go up to the higher planets. And if we do bad karma, we don't go down. So this is the place where we're earning karma.
我们就是我们为自己制造 karma 的业报之地，如果做了前程活动就晋升，如果做了这个活动就往下坠落。
To go up to Brahma Loka you have to have a lot of very 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 good karma.
要去 Brahma Loka 就需要大量大量的这种好的 karma.
Brahma is the most pious person
Brahma 是最虔诚的，是最虔诚的人。
下一个问题。
下一个问题还是小草麻烦鸡的问题，请问 Guru， Gopal Kumar 是 Vrindavan 的牧牛童，他已经很完美了，为什么还要当 Indra Brahma 呢？
OK。
他是聆听了那个早上的那个讲课，
OK。OK， well Gopal Kumar was.Traveling, and he went there. He wanted to go to the higher planets. He went there to heavenly planets. He went to Satyaloka. When he went there, he got these positions. He found out what it was like. He actually got the position of being Indra, and then he got the position to be Brahma. So he could experience what it was like to be in these positions. He was endeavoring, he wanted to meet the Lord of the Universe, and he wanted to develop his relationship with the Lord of the Universe. And when he became Indra, then he got to have more relationship. And when he became Brahma, he got to have even more relationship. When he became Indra, he was with Lord Vamanadeva. Lord Vamanadeva would be personally with him many times. He'd get a lot of association. When he became Lord Brahma, he got to have a lot of contact with the Mahapurush. Mahapurush is the form of the Lord in Brahma Loka. Yes, it could be all of these things. It could be all of these things. You're reading the scriptures. You have to learn how to use this knowledge when you're preaching. But you're not really a preacher. You're working. You've got your job. You don't get a lot of time for preaching.
您读了经典,但是还没有正确的应用,您传教,但您的工,您不是一个传教士,您有自己的工作,您还得上班工作。
So that knowledge which you're getting from the scriptures is good. You keep reading, you get more knowledge, and in the future you'll get more opportunity to use it.
这样呢,
It'd be good for you to give classes sometimes.
有的时候您讲课,
you've been reading a lot of books, you have to share the knowledge you've got. So you should try to do more preaching work. That will help you to use that knowledge which you've got from the scriptures. Shai Gawanti.
好的，下一个问题。经典当中说，随时想着Krishna，用言语、心意和躯体活动为Krishna祝福。那我随时想到Guru，想到圣恩帕帕德，没有想到Krishna，效果是不是一样的呢？一样，没问题，可以。下一个问题。好的，下一个还是Chandra Velasani，麦德吉。 请教Guru，我现在还没有发展出您刚讲到的Brahma的品质，那我做父爱服务是不是没怎么取悦 Krishna？取悦 Krishna的程度非常低，是这样吗？
The qualities of the Brahmana, the main thing is that you follow the four regulated principles. No meat, fish and eggs, no intoxication, no gambling, no illicit sex, and chant 16 rounds. That's a good qualification for Brahmana. Other qualities you can develop.
就这个思想规范原则，不赌博，不服麻醉品，没有非法的性行为，唱念诵十六圈，就是发展婆罗门品质的一个很好的一个基础。从这个就衍生出其他的优秀品质。
When Prabhupada would give initiation, second initiation, he would just ask like that, are you following the four principles? Are you chanting 16 rounds? Okay. Then you can become Brahmana.
当时的Prabhupada给予二次启迪的时候，他就会问，你有没有遵守这四项规范原则，有没有念诵十六圈？ 如果回答是肯定的话，他就会给予二次启迪。
Yeah, and the qualities will develop as you go on. As you practice Krishna consciousness, gradually you develop the qualities.
随着逐步的进步，逐步的修习 Krishna 之觉，就会渐渐的发展出优秀品质。
Important things are like cleanliness and truthfulness.
重要的是真诚以及清洁。
So you try to keep these qualities, try to be truthful and try to be clean.
因此就您努力的就保持这两种两个这两件事，一个是真诚。 一个是捷径。
Okay. Yes. 下一个问题。
好的，下一个问题，Yamuna Tirumadhaji，顶拜Guru，顶拜翻译。请问Guru， Mahabharata当中的Bharata王指的是 Rishabha王的儿子，还是Dushanta王的儿子呢？ Dushanta。
I don't know. I'd have to see the context. How they're speaking about him? What's he doing?
我不知道，我得看上下文。就是怎么说到他的，以他的是什么活动？
There's a lot of things in the Mahabharata. It could be this Bharat. It could be the other Bharat.
这本书当中有那样的内容，也可能是这位巴尔，也可能是另外一个巴尔。下一个问题。好的，下一个问题。Divya Shakti Mataji，顶拜Guru，感谢翻译。感官、心意和智性都是有人格性的吗？他们是活跃的还是死的物质能量？
Yeah, they're ujjadanangliang. They're material energy.
他们是物质能量。
But they get the energy. You see, within the senses, there's the power to activate the sense. Just like a dead body. A dead body has eyes and they have hands and they have everything. But there's no feeling, there's no sensations in them. They can't do anything. The power of the senses is not there. Although the organs are there, but the power to actually perceive knowledge is not there. The eyes can't see anything. We still have eyes. We still have a nose. We can't smell anything. Because there's no soul.
有这种活动的能量，也在感官当中，正如在死尸当中，也有眼睛。 手，但是死士呢却没有感觉，没有一种感情。但是，当这个灵魂在身体当中的时候呢，灵魂它就有这种，这感官就能或就有力量，眼睛就能够看见，鼻子也能够闻到。
So that life, the living force in the senses, that comes from the soul.
这个感官当中的这种生命力是来自灵魂。
And at the time of death, that goes away with the soul.
在死亡之际，这个生命力就连同着，跟随着灵魂就离开了这个躯体。
It's a good question. Interesting question. Yeah, the senses are they have consciousness. But where does that consciousness come from?Actually, what is enjoying, it's not the senses that enjoy, it's the mind which enjoys. The senses don't enjoy, the pleasure is in the mind. The mind is the root of all the senses.So when we talked about enjoying with the senses, it's actually the mind which is enjoying. The senses are not really enjoying. So this is all coming from the mind, from the subtle body. The subtle body is therefore connected there to the...to the senses.
So it's 精微的躯体，精微的躯体是跟粗糙的躯体就有连接着的。
When we feel some pain, we feel the pain. The pain is actually in the mind. It's not in the body. The senses are not feeling the pain. It's the mind is feeling the pain.Okay, 下一个问题。
好，我们的最后一个问题了。Gita Govinda Madaji，顶拜咕噜和翻译，请问主 Rishabhadeva 所展示的 Avaduta 的特征，是告诉我们当一个灵魂完全恢复灵性的身份后达到完美，也会有这样的特征吗？还是只有主和主特殊的伟大奉献者才会有这样的特征呢？
最后一部分，第二部分。So the first part is saying that is this the character, the Avaduta is the character of a pure devotee?
The character that exhibited by Lord Rishabhadeva, is it only, is it that, it's telling us that when a soul completely regains his spiritual identity and attain perfection, he can also have this kind of a characteristic, or only Lord and Lord's special great devotee have this kind of a characteristic?
Yes, character. Yes, this is a very special level of renunciation, this position of avaduta. I said there were only three avadutas practically in the history of the world, you know, and people like Lord Nityananda and Sukadeva Goswami and Rishabdev. So it's a very unique situation, very special position, not something we're supposed to imitate. But there are some people who do try to imitate this. And their stool and urine is not it's not fragrant. So Lord Rishabdev is exhibiting very special type of renunciation. And you can see how the people received him, what they thought of it. They were not very nice to him. You can read in the 11th canto, it describes about the Brahmana from Avanti Desh, and the Brahmana, how he renounced the world and he became a sannyasi. He would go begging everywhere, and people would do similar things, just as happened to Rishabdev. They would do like that to him. Srila Prabhupada said it's good for devotees to go to beg, like in India, it's kind of sometimes they do like that, go begging. Because that way you get used to people insulting you, and that's a good training in tolerance. When people are nasty and insulting to you, it trains you to be more tolerant. Okay. What was Maman Jintian Dao Jer? Kaima? Sati?
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay.
现在好一点，对，多休息。好的，Gurudev，感恩您，好，Hare Krishna，Hare
Krishna，感恩Guru Mani，谢谢Guru Mani，谢谢，谢谢Maharaj，谢谢Sati。